You were saying that the you had found that the mother and child unit, the parenting unit, had actually had a fewer people. At times of conflict and stress, are you finding that's increasing, or what's the position with mental health and women and such like
It's
in those
very,
units?
yeah, sure. I've seen the one article that I got the interview recently, this PTSD and trauma. And then let me go back to 2012, there's a 1 week war in Gaza. And then that, what is, by the way, fantastic, UNRWA, during that war, almost 70, 80% of staff still came to health center and they work, even the bombardment time. So it's really admire them. And then that, so after the end of the war, I went to Gaza. And then that I visited health center. It's primarily to say that thank you very much for your fantastic work during the war. And then that I learned that I saw that some mothers gathering together, and then that one of the nurses are explaining something. Of course, it was in Arabic, so I didn't understand. But
Yes.
what I noticed, the mothers are very seriously listening. Everybody was listening very seriously and raised question. We often do the health education for the mothers are waiting outside the clinic, right? Outside the room. But usually many people don't listen or somebody just sleeping or somebody listening. It's like this. But at that time, everybody was serious. And so I asked them what this nurse is talking about. And they told me she was talking about how to manage your child or children after the war. And how do you respond to the changes or stresses the children have? And I was totally somehow moved. And so on that day, I visited three health centers. And intentionally, I went to the mother and child clinic, which is basically for the antenatal, postnatal care, and the vaccination, the immunization, right?
Yes.
And then I met almost dozens of mothers who brought their children for the vaccination or something. It's not for the illnesses, but for the routine vaccination, the follow-up. And I asked almost a dozen of mothers, and without exaggeration, without, all of them told me that my children are different. My child is different now. It's almost 1 month after the end of
Really?
the 2012 war. And then
Yeah.
they told me that my kids don't sleep, my kids don't eat, my kids don't speak, or cry at night, night waiting, or holding her mother tight, something like
Yes,
this.
yeah.
And then that we started, we reviewed the statistics, and it's true that we provide a psychological trauma and the PTSD care because we have a counselor in health center. The number is doubled after the war, and particularly among youth, young children, so seeking care for the PTSD and the psychological trauma. So it is a major problem. And so now I'm very much concerned about this, more than almost close to 3 weeks war. And what would happen after this? And because you remember that in Gaza, the situation itself, with or without war, is stressful. It's a blockade.
Stressful.
Yeah. And then that other example I can share with you that on my very first visit to Gaza, I visited a women's center, and there's a gathering of around 20 women. And then it's a sort of this debate club. And on that day, the topic of debate was gender discrimination. And it's all mother, all married mother. And then that I went in and asked, say hello. And then I asked, how about gender-based violence or domestic violence? Is it predominant or do you have? And all the mothers said, yes. And it's not only physical, but the verbal. I said, okay, I should be careful with my wife or something like this. And I said, what should I do? And I'm Seita from the health department. Is there anything I can do for you? And I said, shall I come to your house and beat your husband for you or something? Everybody laughed. That's okay. But, everybody asked me the same question, same thing. When they ask you, what can I do for you for the domestic violence? Everybody asks the same question, same thing, which is give job to my husband. Give job to my husband.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because unemployment is extremely high. Then, so that, in this part of masculine nature, the society, men have to nurture, protect, nurture family. And that's a social value, cultural value. And what he can't do it because of no job. And so frustrated, and then what's happened after that? And so that is a general, very high unemployment blockade and a very bad economy and a bad infrastructure. So it's totally frustrating. Probably people in Gaza are the most frustrated or traumatized population and young population in the world.
In the world.
And then now, what's happening now and after the war and after this? And then I'm sorry to say, but many people saw the unbelievable miseries, or say like loss of their families or loss of their friends or neighbors. I'm very much worried about the mental or psychological trauma. And then that this is what we are discussing now, how we can prepare ourselves. Of course, hoping for the end of the war comes soon, but what we are going to bring the back, bring the children back to the normal, I can't say normal, but a better situation mentally and psychologically after the end of the war. That is a major challenge now. Yeah. And then this is extremely, extremely important. Yeah.